My name is Justin Farlow. We're at UCSF, the University of California at San Francisco. I've been here for, at this point, 6 years. And in particular, our laboratory is geared towards understanding the mechanisms of breast cancer and understanding the mechanisms of communication between cells and how that communication can be can go wrong and how that communication can be fixed and how that communication can be restored. It's a job that feels good to do. You're going to help. You're doing nothing but helping people. It's very difficult to do this in a malicious way. You're always doing something that will advance society. In graduate school, there are a number of different phases. There are the phases where you're doing experiments and you're actually seeing results. And on those days, when you come into lab and things are working, which is actually fairly rare, but when things do work and you sit on the microscope, and especially in my case, I'm actually watching individuals move around, and I get to see things that nobody's ever seen before. I get to understand something that is very visual, very obvious, and again, I'm the first person in the world to see that. And that's interesting, and it's fun to be able to then share that with other people. Then there are significant days where you're not doing a lot of lab work, and you're not doing fancy experiments, but you're doing research, and you're learning new things that other people have gone out there and discovered. And finally, there were a significant number of days where I teach or I'm presenting my work to somebody, and that was fulfilling to me to be able to take the discoveries that I have made, put them in the context of the discoveries that other people have made, and present those to somebody else to teach them what I've done or what has been done. So, all of those are rewarding. My mother is a music director, teaches orchestra, and my father is an attorney. I've always been interested in seeing how things work, not particularly in scientific mechanisms, but just seeing how things work, be they social mechanisms like a government, or be they, you know, I grew up outdoors in the woods of Indiana, so seeing just how an animal, an ecosystem works, and I found that in just keep asking more and more questions, you just keep having to take more and more school, but things also keep getting more interesting. And so, in that, our basic questions will allow us to understand fundamental concepts with respect to cancer, disease, and organization of a human body. Being a researcher takes a significant amount of time and dedication, and there are days where you work significantly harder than you think you might. But on the other hand, we have significant flexibility. We have the ability to spend a week or two at a coffee shop doing our research, and it is. We're actually doing hardcore science in a coffee shop. And so there's something rewarding about being able to do that. Personally, I grew up in the woods, so I like spending time outside, spending time, and San Francisco's pretty nice because within an hour or two, you can be at the ocean, you can be at the mountains, you can be at the redwood forests. So I enjoy that. Additionally, I always liked working with my hands, and so a friend and I have built a rally car, so an off-road racing car, which we take every once in a while and enter races in. We've built a roll cage in the car, and we've been able to race it, and so that's been pretty cool. So we do some other things outside of lab. Basic science and curiosity in and of itself, I think, is sometimes undervalued, or the impact that you can have just by being curious can be significant, and you don't know what that impact is. And if you just rely on the fact that you don't know, rely on the fact that you are ignorant about what might come about, the creativity that you invest into your project is sufficient to learn something interesting. There will be significant impact. It just may not be obvious.